Hello, welcome back. I'm building the engine. I did a live stream actually of these, so unfortunately you probably missed it if you were not on my Facebook page. Just the block and the fan assembly. A little fiddly, a bit of an issue with the photo etch. This piece of photo etch that goes around it, around the, looks like the filter, just isn't long enough. So I got it round, you can see it, and there's still a couple of millimeters gap, so I'm going to make a piece to fill that. I'm going to fabricate that and we'll make that right. Very disappointing, but occasionally you get that with photo etch, you know, it doesn't always fit very well. That's when you have to kind of try and work it out, but other than that, not too bad. There's the engine block. Okay, we're going to finish that right now, and then we'll have a complete engine. I've already done the, I didn't actually do the fan assembly and radiator yesterday because I had to primer everything, so I did that and gave it a coat. I'm losing my voice a little bit today. I've noticed a lot of really small bits of sprue, like, sorry, flash, bits of flash inside some of the smaller parts, so be aware of that. If you're making this kit, you'll see them and they'll pop up. I'm going to put a little clamp on that. for a second. Right. Show you the other pieces. Try and do something about that seam. A little bit. And then get the sander in there. Try and sand it that seam down a little bit. The primer should take care of that. We'll use some Mr. Surfacer maybe. Definitely want to see that when we get the primer on. Okay. I've got to say, it is an amazing kit. It's another Ryfield work of art. They do have their flaws, definitely not without trials and tribulations, but I think, as you can see with, well, even just the chassis, the end result is always quite amazing. Oops. They're not glued on yet, those. Cool. So, yeah, we're on. Nice. And there's the engine. Really nice. Now, it has a fan here to go on, but I'm not going to put that on yet because I want to hand paint all these and that's just going to get in the way. I mean, he's going to go in there like that, and it's going to get in the way. I've got to hand paint all these belts, so we'll get on to that next.
Good morning. Right, we've completed the engine block build, apart from the pipes, so I'm going to give them a coat of grey, Mr. Surfacer 1000, and because the engine block is going to be yellow, normally I'd use black, but the black will be too dark underneath the yellow, plus we've also got to hand paint some of the other pulleys and the parts and bits and pieces with various different colours, so grey makes a much better base behind colours than black, because black darkens everything. So there you go. Alright. Pardon the background noise, I've got the window open. As before, small parts, stick them on a piece of tape. Stops them from flying around. It's a small amount of Mr. Color thinners. Always use this. Mr. Color products are always compatible. You do have to use the same thinners with their primer, as far as I know. I go with about 30-70 with a mix. Now, if you're using this with the surfacer, it's pretty stinky. So make sure you've got a window open. To let the fumes out, otherwise you'll be tripping balls, as they say. All right. It's gone fairly thin, so you give it a couple of coats. That's another. Okay, I just flip those over. Whoop, there it goes. We're going to do these black. Wait. And see, they do fly everywhere. It's okay. That's fine. Still got some left here, so I'm going to carry on with one more coat until we run out, and that'll be it. This surface is great stuff because you can sand it. It sands down beautifully. There it is. Cool. Okay, so I've masked up the engine. I'm going to do the back end. I've looked at some pictures for reference, and I'm going to do the back end, basically the desert tan color, and then this front engine box is going to be yellow. I've got Farm Tractor yellow Mission models, and then I'm going to hand detail the engine because some of the pulleys and the belts and whatnot are greys and black and a few other different colours. So there you go, let's go. Good. Let it dry for a bit. Okay, we're drying out. Let's remove that masking tape carefully. Nice. Perfect.
Right, we'll mask off that bit and then we'll spray the front. I used to be a masking tape. I find it's pretty much the best for this kind of work. Just put a little piece around that. Fingers and thumbs. Stay down on your devil, there you go. We'll get the bulk of the colour done with the spray, and then we'll hand brush areas where I couldn't get to with the brush, just to tidy it up. I want to kind of keep that grey. Actually, you know what? We'll just cut around it. I think we'll be fine. Cool. Farm tractor yellow. Give these a really good shake. It's a brand new bottle.
edge, right? Okay, let's try. Let's take off that masking tape. Nice. Gonna do that top piece black, and we're gonna pick out the pulleys and the belts with a brush and a few items. This little bar here needs to be the same color as that. Other than that, kind of like it. Looks pretty good. That's great.